We are here at the 2018 edition of the Architecture Biennial in Venice. And from the color around us, you can maybe assume where we are. We are looking, we are talking to one of the curators, co-curators of this, of the Pavilion of the Netherlands. And she will explain us a little bit about the concept and what is behind this installation.
Yes, thank you. So welcome to Work Body Leisure, the Dutch Pavilion. We claim in this exhibition that the Netherlands is and has always been a testing ground for the future of labor and where this future continues to be reimagined. And as we see at this moment, there is a lot of changes in work also because of automation. We invited a series of architects, researchers, designers, musicians to look at particular architectures where the tension between work and leisure becomes very tangible, and also ask how our human bodies are involved in this changing labor conditions. So for instance, we invited Mark Wigley, who has been doing a lot of research about the work of Constant Nieuwenhuis, and in particular New Babylon. And New Babylon was really a society where Constant imagined a post-labor world in which people would actually design their own environments. And as we see later in his work, actually the violence is still present in this, in the society. So we also created a reproduction of his painting, but you will also found the labor, the robots that actually made this reproduction. And then we have the bed, a contribution by Beatrice Colomina, and she imagines the bed as a horizontal architecture for work, as a workplace. Then there is the work of Simone Nikia, who is talking about the softwares that are used to design ergonomic work environments. And the body is always represented, an average body. And she is looking at what that actually means, like whose bodies are actually represented. We also have automated landscapes, research that we started at the New Institute in Rotterdam 2 years ago, where we're looking at how the built environment is changing because of automation. So when you enter the harbor in Rotterdam, in fact, there's a lot of terrains where humans have no access anymore because they're completely controlled by robots through people working from control rooms. Then lastly, we have the Door of No Return, a contribution by Amal Alhaj. And she is looking at this particular Door of No Return, where captured and enslaved bodies were brought to the new world. And she looks at this particular door as a site also for science fiction and for news stories. So next to these contributions, you can all enter them through the locker room, the orange locker room. We also did an open call for contributions. So you will find even more projects inside the other lockers. So there's different ways to experience the pavilion. When you enter, you will find the locker room, also as an architecture that explains a bit this tension between spaces for work and leisure. So it could be a place for leisure where you enter here. And at the same time, we look at these really individualized spaces of the locker, where people like have their own personal belongings, store them when they change from a human being also into a worker. So.
And I think people really enjoy it. So they like to interact with all the doors. They are curious what is behind. And bottom line, you have a test facility for materials. So how long does the doors last?
I think they're built in a proper way, but it's really interesting to see the interactions that are happening also between the rooms and the main space, the locker room. For instance, there are also the peek-in lockers. Sometimes people are behind there and they have interesting interactions. But also during the opening days, we try to activate the spaces. So we invited the contributors to activate the spaces in their own way. Yesterday, we recreated the bedroom of John Lennon and Yoko Ono. And Beatrice Colomina interviewed a series of architects and researchers in the bed. And today we will continue our program. Yes.
Good luck, and thank you for giving us your opinions and your insights. Thanks.
Thank you. with the microphone.